Hello students, in the previous video I have explained you the divisibility rules of 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. In this video I am going to explain you the divisibility rules of 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. How will you test the divisibility of any number by 7? Firstly I am going to explain you that. So I am going to make you understand by an example. So firstly I will explain the example, then I will read the rule for you. Can you see this number? 6804. Now how will you identify that this number is divisible by 7 or not? So the rule of divisibility rule of 7 says that any number is divisible by 7 if the digit at ones place, or the digit at unit place. As I told you, both are same. If the digit at ones place or the unit place is twice. Twice means we have to multiply it by 2, so it will become 8. Is subtracted from the rest of the number. Now rest of the number is 680. जब हम लोग unit digit को twice करके यानी double करके बचे number से rest of the number से subtract करते हैं और जो हमारा answer आता है, अगर वो आपका 7 से divisible है, तो वो number भी आपका 7 से divisible होगा. So this is the rule of 7. So we have to check whether 672 is divisible by 7 or not. 672. Now 7 9s are 63. 7 6s are 42. So as we can see, this is divisible by 7. So to check the divisibility of any number by 7, what you have to do is the first step is to twice the number at units place. You have to double it. After doubling the number, you have to subtract it from the rest of the number. Then you will get an answer. That answer should be divisible by 7. That means then the number will be divisible by 7. If in exams any question is given to you to check the divisibility of any number by 7, so you have to follow every step. So I am reading the rule for you. A number is divisible by 7 if the difference between twice the unit digit and the number formed by the other digits is either 0 or a multiple of 7. It can be 0 also. यहाँ पे जो हमारा answer आया है, या तो ये 7 से divisible होना चाहिए, या फिर ये answer हमारा 0 आना चाहिए. Only then the number will be divisible by 7. एक example और ले लेते हैं. I'm going to take one more example. 137. Now the digit at units place is doubled, it will become 14. Okay students, when I am going to double it, it will become 14. So we have to subtract it from the rest of the number. So 14 minus 13 is 1. So it is not divisible by 7. So therefore 137 is not divisible by 7. Now I am going to take one more example for you. We have to check it. Now double the unit digit, it will be 6. Now 14 minus 6 is 8. This is also not divisible by 7. So this is how we check the numbers. Now I'm going to explain you the next rule, that test of divisibility of 8. Please pay attention. So students, now I'm going to explain you the next divisibility test, that is of 8. So what is the rule of 8? How will you check the divisibility of any number by 8? The test of divisibility of 8 and the rule says that any numbers, the digit at 1's place, 10's place and 100's place. We have to look for 3 positions. 1's, 10's, 100. Any number is divisible by 8 if the digit, the 3 digits at 1's, 10's and 100's place are divisible by 8. आगे इसके आपके चाहे जितने डिजिट्स हो, 1, 2, 3, 4, the digits can be like this also. But these 3 digits should be divisible by 8, only then the number will be divisible by 8. Why we are taking 3 digits? In 6 we have taken 2, 3s are 6. So we have applied the rule of 2 also and we have applied the rule of 3 also. Here in 8, we have taken 3 digits because when we will take the LCM of 8, it goes like this. That means 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2. So the prime factorization of 8 is 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2. 3 times 2 is there. So we have to check at 3 places. Ones, tens and hundreds. So let's take some examples in order to understand this. So as per the rule of 8, the first example which I am going to take is 152. So let's check whether this number is divisible by 8 or not. Ones, tens, hundred. We will divide it by 8. 8 ones are 8. Now, 8 nines are 72. Yes, students. So, 152 is divisible by 8. Now, I am going to take one more example. 7, 9, 1, 6, 8. Now, we have to check the divisibility of last 3 digits. So, 168 is divisible by 8 or not. Let's check. 8 2's are 16. Now, 8 1's are 8. So, this is divisible by 8. So, this whole number is divisible by 8. So, to test the divisibility of 8, we have to check the digits at 1's, 10's and 100's place. If the digit formed by 3 places, if the number formed by these 3 places is divisible by 8, then the whole number is divisible by 8. Now, I am going to explain you the rule of 9. Please pay attention. So, the rule of 9 says that a number is divisible by 9 if some of its digits is divisible by 9. Please recall the rule of 3, jo maine aapko kal samjhaya tha. What was the rule of 3? The rule of 3 says that if some of the digits of a particular number is divisible by 3, then that number is divisible by 3. So, same goes with 9. If some of the digits of that number is divisible by 9, then that whole number is divisible by 9. So, we are going to take one example to explain. We have to add the numbers. 6 plus 5, 11. 11 plus 0, 11. 11 plus 4, 15. 15 plus 3 will be 18. So, 18 is divisible by 9. That means this whole number is divisible by 9. Let's take one more example. 8, 1, 3, 2, 6. Now we are going to add up the digits. 8 plus 2 is 10. 10 plus 3, 13. 13 plus 1, 14. 14 plus 6. 14 plus 6 is 20. So is this number is divisible by 9? No, because 20 is not divisible by 9. So this is how we check the divisibility of 9. Now I am going to explain you the divisibility rule of 10. Please pay attention. The rule of 10 is very easy as the rule of 5. In 5, what was the rule? Please recall, students, what was the rule in 5? The rule of 5 says that if the unit digit is 0 or 5, then the number is divisible by 5. So, same goes with 10. We have to check the unit digit. Unit digit means the digit at 1's place. If it is 0, then the whole number will be divisible by 10. I am going to read the rule for you. A number is divisible by 10 if its 1's digit or unit digit is 0. So, 30, 100, 50, 150, 900, all of these numbers are divisible by 10. Now, I am going to explain you the rule of 11. Please pay attention, students. So, students, now I am going to read the rule for you. How will you check the divisibility of any number by 11? A number is divisible by 11 if the difference of sum of its digits in odd places and the sum of its digit in even places is starting from the ones place is either 0 or a multiple of 11. Now, how will you check? This rule is quite similar to 7. In 7, what was the rule? We used to double the unit digit and subtract it from the rest of the number. Now, but 11, the situation is slightly different. I am taking one example to make you understand. What you have to do is, you have to add the number at even places and the number at odd places. So, this, this and this. 1, 3, 5. This is odd place. Now, I am going to add it. 9 plus 7 plus 8. And this is even place. 2 and 4. 0 plus 2. You have to add like this separately. So, 9 plus 8 plus 7 is equals to 24. Now, 0 plus 2 is 2. Now, what you have to do? You have to subtract it. these two you have to subtract. So 24 minus 2 will be 22, right? So is 22 divisible by 11? Yes, you all are right. 22 is divisible by 11. It comes in the table of 11. So this number is divisible by 11. If we would have got here 0, in spite of 22, agar hame 0 mila hota, then also it would have been divisible by 11. Now let's take one more example to make you understand. 863423. 863423. Now 135, right? 246. Now 8 plus 3 plus 2, 6 plus 4 plus 3. It will be 13 and it will be 13. Now 13 minus 13 is 0. Yes, you all are right. So we have got what? 0. So in the rule of 7, it was there ki aapka jo result aayega wo ya to 7 se divisible hona chahiye ya 0 hona chahiye. Same goes with 11. The answer should be divisible by 11 or it should be 0. So yahan pe what we have got? We have got 0. That means this number is divisible by 11. Now I am going to take some examples like questions to make you understand. Please pay attention. So students, as you can see, I have taken some examples written on the board. So firstly, we will check the divisibility of these numbers by 7. So as per the rule of 7, I have to double the unit digit at units place. So 2 times 8 is 16. Now I have to subtract 16 from this rest of the number. 6 minus 6 is 0, 3 minus 1 is 2. 2520. Now we have to check whether it is divisible by 7 or not. I am going to divide it here for you. Yes, students, as we can check, this number is divisible by 7. So it is divisible by 7 because the remainder is 0. Now I am going to check this number 6 times. 6, we have to double the number, unit digit. So 2 times 6 is 12. So we have to subtract it from 82. So what we have got? We have got 70. 7 times are 70. So this number is also divisible. Now the next one, 7 times, so 2 times 7 is 14. Now 14 minus 11 is 3, which is not divisible. So this number is not divisible by 7. Now as per the rule of 8, we have to check the last 3 digits whether it is divisible by 8 or not. So I am going to check it for you. I have to divide 364 by 8. Now 8 fours are 32. We have got what? 44. So it is not divisible by 8 because we have not got the remainder 0. So this number is not divisible by 8. Now I am going to check for the next number. Please pay attention. 976. So the next number is 136,976. So we have to check that last 3 digits whether they are divisible by 8 or not. So 976 we have to check. I am going to divide it by 8 and check. 8 to the 16. Again we got 1. 8 to the 16. That means this number is divisible by 8. Right. Now I am going to check for the next. Last 3 digits will be taken. I am going to divide it by 8. 8 nines are 72. We have got over here 7 again. So 8 nines are 72. So this number is also divisible by 8. So all the three, first apart from this number, these two numbers are divisible by 8. Now I am going to take examples for 9 and 11. For 10 I am not taking because you just have to check the digit at unit place. It should be 0. Okay, students. So students, I have written few numbers. We have to check the divisibility of these numbers. So firstly I am going to check it by 9. So as per the rule of 9, what we have to do is we have to add all the digits. If the digits are the answer is divisible by 9, then the whole number is divisible by 9. So 9 plus 1 is 10, 10 plus 7, 17, 17 plus 2 is 19, 19 plus 8 is 27, right? 19 plus 8 is 27. So 27 is divisible by 9 or not? Please pay attention. Yes, students, you all are right. 27 is divisible by 9. Now I am going to check for the next number. We have to add the digits. 2 plus 5, 7, 7 plus 7, 14, 14 plus 1, 15, 15 plus 6, 21. So 21 is divisible by 9 or not? Yes, you all are right. 21 is not divisible by 9. Now I am going to check for the next number. 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 3, 9, 9 plus 3, 12. Is 12 divisible by 9? Yes, students, you all are right. It is not divisible by 9. Now I am going to check for 11. I have written 3 numbers. So I am going to check the divisibility by 11. So the rule of 11 was that you have to add the digit at odd places and even places and subtract both the results. So digit at odd places are 1 plus 7 plus 6. Now here the digit at even places, 3 plus 2 plus 9. 3 plus 2 plus 9. Now I'm going to add it for you. 7 plus 1 is 8, 8 plus 6 is 14. 9 plus 3, 12, 12 plus 2, 14. So 14 minus 14 is 0. So we have got 0. So this number is divisible by 11. Now I am going to check for the next. 8 plus 7 plus 1. 8 plus 7 plus 1. It will be 16. Now 3 plus 2. It will be 5. So 16 minus 5 is 11. This is also divisible by 11. Now I am going to check for the next number. Yes. So 8 plus 9 plus 3 plus 2 and 7 plus 0 plus 2. 7 plus 0 plus 2. So 8 plus 2 is 10. 10 plus 9 is 19. 19 plus 3 is 22. And here 7 plus 2 is 9. So 22 minus 9 is, students, please tell me. 22 minus 9 will be 13, right? 22 minus 9 will be 13, which is not divisible by 11. So this number is not divisible by 11. So I hope you all have understood the concept of divisibility of 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. By the end of this video, I am going to give you few questions based on this. I hope you must have understood. Please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.